Guys, it's March, so you know what that means, right? It means it's Women's Yes. History Month. Look, let's face it, even though a woman can do anything, there's still a lot of stereotypes that try to limit us or just hide how great we really are. So we're making strides in politics, education, and in the workforce. So today, we are highlighting those everyday women who are showing up and knocking down barriers in traditionally male-dominated careers. This is Women for the Win!
Is it just me, or do you all get that proud feeling when you see a woman you may know, not even, maybe not even know it, but they're working in construction? Well, according to The Insider, when it comes to construction, women make up about 9.9% of the industry.
That's right, Lonnie.
Wow.
And, but we all know that soon that number will change because us women will not be limited. And I am so excited right now because we found a woman who operates the heavy machinery that we all see at construction sites. Yeah, she's back there. They don't just give the keys to anyone, by the way, because you have to be skilled. And I can't wait to meet this amazing woman. Please welcome Amanda Duong to the show. Hi, Amanda. Thank you for being here.
Hi, Amanda.
Thank you for having me.
Hello, yes. Amanda.
Get your vest on.
Okay, I have to ask, what made you pursue a career in construction?
Well, construction wasn't the plan when I first started out. I first started in university wanting to go actually into biochemistry, but I got a job. I had both my parents who were already in the construction industry. I grew up actually admiring my mom. She worked in a male-dominant field. She was never afraid to get her hands dirty or work alongside any men. So while I was in university, I got a summer job at the construction site as just the labor. And I soon realized I actually really enjoyed working in the construction industry and I wanted to be a part of it a lot more. So I actually ended up just getting the necessary training and requirements that I needed for my heavy equipment operating, and here I am today.
Wow,
that's a great story. So your mom obviously was a role model to you. I have to ask you, have you experienced any issues or hurdles as a woman, you know, in a male-dominated industry?
Yes, definitely. I've had experienced quite a bit of hurdles over the years. I had to overcome quite a bit of sexism and misogynist mindset. There's not a lot of men who are really open to working with or alongside a woman. So I've also had to deal with quite a bit of racism as well, a bit of racist comments and the views. It took a bit of time, but those who had that perception, it slowly began to change. And now, as they saw my commitment and worth ethic, everything kind of began to shift.
Wow, I'm glad that it's shifting, but can you share or give an example of some of the things you've been through?
Yes, definitely. There's been times where I've been working outside grading and I've had to deal with some civilians. I've had a man come up to my grader while I was working and rip my grader door open and ask me, what am I doing? And I told him what I was doing and he started to yell at me and say, I want a man here. Do you even know what you're doing? Do you even know your material?
No.
Do you even know
no.
the roads? And
no.
I told him, like, you know, I'm just here to do my job. There are times where when I have to deal with some civilians where I don't necessarily say the nicest thing back, but I am just trying to do my job. There are times where there are times where I've actually had to call my supervisor to help back me up because there have been some really aggressive folks out there as well.
Oh, I'm sorry.
Oh my gosh. That is horrible. I can't even imagine that you'd have to experience something like that.
Yeah.
As a woman, have you ever felt afraid to make mistakes when there are people watching who believe that you don't belong there?
Yeah, there's definitely been times where I felt like I couldn't really make any mistakes, that everything had to be perfect and that I had to learn fast to really be perfect because I felt like the pressure was really, really on. I had to really make sure that I proved to them that I could be there as a woman and that I deserved the equal chance just as much as they did. I didn't even want to even allow them that thought that I couldn't. So now with those I've been working with for years, they slowly began to change. And now that they would say that I'm a very hardworking person, and some of them would even say I work harder than some of the guys.
I'll bet.
Yeah.
I'll bet.
Amanda, what are your hopes for women in construction?
Through my social media, I've been trying to really help break that perception by showing myself working in heavy equipment, because a lot of people, when they think construction, they of a girl in construction, they just think of just a flag girl or just a female truck driver. They don't actually think of a woman who drives the heavy equipment itself. So I'm trying to really help break that perception and hope that we can reframe people's perception so it's not as tough for future women, just like my mom did for her industry.
Oh, wow.
I really hope that happens too. I have to ask you, Amanda, what kind of characteristics do you think is essential for a woman to succeed in construction?
So for whatever trade that a woman is going to be getting into, I think it's really important that you make sure you are getting the right credentials that you need that really keeps you competitive and make sure that no one can really tell you that you are not going to be qualified for the job and that you can't do it. Right. You also really need to make sure that you are mentally strong, thick-skinned, and have the perseverance, because it's going to take a lot of strength to endure the ignorance that is out there. And to really take the time to let your work speak for itself. And there are also going to be days that are going to seem so much harder than others, but you just really need to make sure that you stay strong and really build the strength, because it's going to take a lot of strength to know when to really just draw the line and to really know when to speak up for yourself. And it's really important to make sure you keep your head high and to really persevere, because you have to remember that you're helping pave the way for future women after you.
And you certainly are. Amanda, beautiful. You're an amazing woman doing great things. Thank you so much for sharing your experiences with us.